Hello students, last time we have seen the force analysis in IC engine mechanism. So in particular this topic we have seen the static force analysis as well as dynamic force analysis. So in particular static force analysis we have seen few equations which is generated by some figure, okay. So here this is a piston force, this is a normal force, this is a force on connecting rod, then force on crank. So these all force we have seen last time, right? So here conclusion, the summary is here, gas force Fg, that is pi by 4 d square Pg, then inertia force, then axial force, then relation between theta and phi, this all equation we have derived last time, right? So I hope you know this equation, you must remember this equation, okay. Today we are going to discuss an example of IC engine force acting on the IC engine mechanism. So start with, in IC engine mechanism the crank radius is given 400 mm and connecting rod is 950 mm, length of connecting rod is 950 mm. And the diameter of piston D is given 100 mm, okay. And the net gas pressure acting on the piston is 15 MPa, matlab PG jo diya hua hai, that is 15 N/mm². And find the thrust in connecting rod, okay. So connecting rod pe jo load lag raha hai wo hume find karna hai, piston side thrust Fn find karna hai, torque find karna hai, theek hai. To yahan pe 45 डिग्री यहाँ पे एंगल दिया हुआ है थीटा, यू नो थीटा राइट, सो इट इज द एंगल ऑफ क्रैंक लाइक दिस, ओके दिस इज 45. देन कैलकुलेट द पिस्टन एफर्ट, यहाँ पे कुछ नहीं करना है, हमें जो आगे इक्वेशन डिराइव किए थे वो हमें रखना है. सो एफ बी दैट इज इक्वल टू एफ जी, ओके. सो पिस्टन फोर्स जो होता है दैट इज इक्वल टू गैस फोर्स, ओके, पाई बाय 4 डी स्क्वायर इंटू पी जी. सो हियर वी कैन इजिली कैलकुलेट पिस्टन फोर्स. देन ऑब्लिक्विटी रेशियो दैट इज एल बाय आर, ओके. सो एल इज द लेंथ ऑफ कनेक्टिंग रोड एंड आर इज द रेडियस ऑफ क्रैंक, सो ऑब्लिक्विटी रेशियो 2.375. देन रिलेशन बिटवीन थीटा एंड फाइ, दैट इज साइन फाइ इज इक्वल टू साइन थीटा अपॉन एन. सो बाय दिस वे वी कैन फाइंड आउट द एंगल ऑफ फाइ, मीन्स हियर दिस फाइ वी कैन इजिली कैलकुलेट, ओके ओके. सो दिस फिगर यू हैव टू रिमेंबर, यू कैन ड्रॉ दिस फिगर एंड देन साइमल्टेनियसली यू कैन सी इन दैट फिगर वेन एवर वी आर डूइंग सम एग्जाम्पल्स. सो phi is given, then fq, thrust in connecting rod, that is fq. So fq is equal to fp upon cos phi, okay. So we can get the thrust load, okay, fq. Then piston side thrust यानी कि एफ एन, जो यहाँ पे इस तरह से पिस्टन था तो यहाँ पे नीचे से जो लोड लग रहा था दैट इज कॉल्ड द एफ एन. सो पिस्टन साइड थ्रस्ट एफ एन इज इक्वल टू एफ पी टेन फाइ, दिस इक्वेशन वी हैव डिराइव्ड. So by putting just value we can find out the normal force, or we can say thrust force. Then calculate the tangential force acting on the crankshaft. Ft is equal to fq sin theta plus phi, there so we have theta, we have phi, we have fq, all the required things over here. So ft, there is a tangential force we can find out easily. Then calculate the torque acting on crankshaft. T is equal to Ft into R. R that is radius of crank. So here you can see the answer 43.70 into 10 raised to 3 Newton into meter. So here mm convert into meter. Then last is calculate the radial force. Fr is equal to Fq cos theta plus phi. So putting all the value and we get the answer. So same way you can see here June 2012 7 marks, and here you can see that is December 2010 7 marks. So these are the very important example for the examination. So let us solve the second example, a vertical IC engine. Here the IC engine is vertical, okay. So one thing you should remember, that whenever horizontal engine is given, then weight is not consideration. We are not going to take consideration. But during the vertical, we have to calculate the weight also, like mass into 9.8 gravitational force. So vertical IC engine has a cylinder bore 150, diameter is given, then stroke length L is given, which is 350. Actually here stroke length is 200. Okay, so stroke length, that is, we can find out 200 by 2, that is 100 mm, that is the crank radius. Okay, so the connecting rod 350 mm long, mass of the reciprocating mass is 1.6 kg. Then during the expansion of the stroke, crank angle theta is given from the TDC, and the gas pressure is given PG, that is 750 kilonewton per meter square. Determine the piston effort when engine runs at 1800 rpm. So rpm is also given. So by using rpm, we can find out omega 2 pi n upon 60, angular velocity of this crank. So one thing I want to repeat, that is crank radius. You, many of you may be not understand 200 by 2. It means, what is a stroke? Stroke means, here we can say, when the crank is over here and it's having a 180 degree, and right now crank is here. So during this distance, the piston also travel that amount of things, okay, that amount of distance. So this distance is piston stroke, that is called the 100, say 100. So here this is also 100 mm, and 200, and 200 by 2, that is 100 mm. Okay, so by this way we can find out the crank radius. So all these things you know very well. Weight we have calculated by putting 9.81. so we have to find the gas force, pi by 4 d square pg. Pi by 4 d is given, data. So pg is also given. Then inertia force, again I am telling you, inertia force only calculate when the piston is vertical. So here inertia force Fi is equal to mr omega square r bracket cos theta plus cos 2 theta upon n. In balancing chapter we have seen this equation. So m omega square r, okay. So yahan pe we have to add the weight. So Fp, total piston force, is equal to gas force minus inertia force plus weight of reciprocating mass. Okay, so here gas piston force is calculated by this way. Now third example. Okay, so today we are going to discuss almost three example, which is almost same. So we take it into single lecture. So single cylinder vertical engine, again vertical engine, 150 mm bore diameter, stroke is 200, means 100 mm radius. Then it is the same thing, June 2011, 7 marks. Okay, so friends, don't miss this chapter, because this is very easy chapter and you can get good marks. Okay, so n is given, all the things is given. Fp, you can find out Fp. Okay, here even though vertical engine, they have not calculated the inertia force. Okay, so it's okay. Fp r, then theta and phi, yahan pe sin theta aega. Okay, sin theta upon n. So phi we can calculate, obliquity ratio, then piston effort, all these things. It is like a same example of previous one, first example. Like, so Fq we can find out, Fn we can find out, Ft we can find out. Okay, these are all are the same equations. So today this is enough for this lecture, and you just solve this example by pausing the video on repeat, watching it repeatedly, and you have calculate these three examples, solve these three examples. So thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.